In 2013, Eminem released the album The Marshall Mathers LP 2 with the song Bad Guy in it. And the chorus, which was wonderfully sung by Sarah Jaffe in that weird raspy singing voice that all white girls like to do on the internet for some reason, it goes like, I just hate to be the bad guy. And most of us would agree with that, right? Well, not everyone, because this subreddit is dedicated to people that are bad people, called r/badpeoplestories. And I'm your host, Zach, of Daily Dose of Reddit, which I'm welcoming you to. You thought you'd catch me slipping, but you didn't. By the way, y'all should give that album a listen. It's like gotten me through some weird teenager days. Anyway, this episode's one story is called My Neighbor Creeped on Me, Keeps Trying to Be Friends, Describes Himself as Harmless. I've been wanting to write this post for weeks. I write for a living, and this will be therapeutic for me. It's a long one. A little about me. I'm a local journalist in a mid-sized Midwestern city. I include this detail so that you know my name is well-known and I have a public presence on Twitter, Facebook, etc. I am used to people knowing who I am, though of course I never expect it, and I'm always a little shocked when someone says, "I read your stuff!" I generally don't mind people striking up conversations or telling me about themselves. More often than not, I ask them all about it. I moved from downtown to a sweet little place in a different part of the city. It's a two-family with a downstairs unit, mine, and a small upstairs unit. From what I understand, the landlord has struggled to rent the upstairs because with where the bathroom is in relation to the roof peak, I guess you have to basically sit down to use the shower. It's a small apartment in general and rents for about half of what I pay. The downstairs unit, where I live, is bigger and has a three-season room off the bedroom, and this little gem came with a miraculous lease. It's a decent price, and what's most important to me, exclusive use of the front and back porches, the back patio and raised garden bed, and both yards. There's a fire pit in the back that the previous tenants left on the back patio. It's perfect. The man who lives upstairs is in his mid-50s. He'd lived there for less than a year when I moved in. He works for the postal service and is very active in the union. My newspaper has a strong union, so I have respect for that. He lives there alone, and within days of meeting him, he's warned me, in so many words, about the fact that he drinks a lot. In fact, the first day I met him, he told me that he left his wife in one of the Dakotas because she was sick, their marriage was falling apart anyway, and, I quote, he
didn't want to be celibate.
Then he shrugged. I'm not sure how to react. He started offering me pasta sauce or dinner when he was making it. I accepted the pasta sauce once. He texted me not long after, bugging me until I returned his container. I never accepted again. And my boyfriend did not like how this guy was acting and didn't want me to engage. I respected that, and obviously by this point had gotten some creeper vibes too. He started texting me about politics and trying to start conversations. As a woman, obviously, I have my guard up basically all the time. I try to be nice, but not engage too much. He's my neighbor and we have to be cordial, after all. Plus, I'm a journalist and I have to remember everyone I meet is a potential source. He'd also asked for help getting his newspaper delivery straightened out. He was having issues with consistency and where he needed it delivered, precisely. I'm always happy to help out with that. It's kind of my job. So I did. One day, not long after, he texted me and called me, "Sweet mate." I can't remember the context of the conversation, but it didn't really matter. I barely knew this pot-bellied man in his 50s and not even divorced from his poor, sick wife with a gray mullet. It hadn't even been a month since I'd moved in. My friends tried to laugh off sweet meats and suggested maybe it was a typo or an autocorrect error. I didn't think they were right, and they weren't. Hours later, he texted me to correct that he'd meant to type sweet meat. Ugh. Days later, he called me little girl in a text message. That was it. If men call me out on the street and I don't like it, that's 100% of the time, by the way, I will yell back and let them know. I lecture anyone I can about what's wrong with the use of the words itch and ut. If you aren't my man, my father, or my brother, you call me by my damn name. A man I barely know addressing me this way is unacceptable, and I let him know. I ask him to please stop using pet names for me, as my boyfriend really did not like it. I find, with men, that if you are a woman and you ask them of something like this, they will not respect you whatsoever. It's just easier to say it's coming from another man, which they seem to take more seriously, sometimes. He responds,
"Okay, but that might be hard. I've never had pets I've called sweet meat or little girl."
And I felt that anger and panic in my stomach. I couldn't place exactly why, but now I can. It was because of the lack of respect and the complete dismissal and joke about what I saw as a very serious issue. I am sure it's going to sound extreme when I say this, but this kind of interaction is threatening to me, as a woman living on my own and in the same building as this stranger. Still, even after I've asked him not to call me anything but my name multiple times, this butthole still calls me babe at the end of every freaking time I am unfortunate enough to have to speak to him.
Alright, see you later, babe.
Step off, dude. So a couple of weeks later, I'm in Florida on vacation. I tweet pictures of the beach, so it's on me a little bit for alerting the world of where I was, but I can't resist capturing and sharing those sunsets. Anyway, he texts me and says,
"You went to Florida without moi?"
And I asked how he knew I was in Florida. He legit said,
"Because I'm stalking you, and stalkers always know where their prey is, silly."
And then soon after,
"No, because I follow you on Twitter."
I responded coldly, "Yeah, that's creepy as frick. Not that you follow me on Twitter, but that you would text me and say that." He said something along the lines of,
"I didn't mean to creep you out. I'm sorry. I've been carrying mail all day. I'm socially awkward sometimes, but I'm harmless."
I think I sniped back again, and he left me alone for a while after that. For a long time, there weren't any interactions besides the occasional hello when we'd passed in the shared laundry space or basement. He had his own machines, and I have mine. When I moved in, I had them arranged the way I wanted them, with the doors facing the right ways so that both could be open and I could shovel clothes in and out. He said he needed to move them a little bit so he wouldn't stumble over them when he's drunk. I said fine, and if you're going to do that, could you go ahead and fasten the screws that attach the washer to its bottom stand and drawer? He said he would. If he was going to be a pain in the ass about this, I might as well get something out of the deal. I also had my dryer on a pallet, in case it flooded, and he said I didn't need it, so he took it off the pallet. He didn't even ask if it was okay, just made the decision without me. He hunts, and his hunting gear is strewn all over his part of the basement. He asked me if he could use the garage for hanging meat, and at first I said sure, but then I tried to go in the garage, once, and the door wouldn't open. I tried to reach around to move what was blocking it, but I could barely fit my hand and arm in the space that did open. I texted him, asking why I couldn't get in the garage, also for my use only, per the lease. He said there are critters who get in there, sometimes. A couple of weeks later, when I told him, "Sorry, you can no longer use the garage, it's getting to be winter and I need to park my car in there," he removed the obstacle. I said, "I hope you found somewhere to store what you got from hunting," and he said,
"I never put anything in there."
I didn't ask, because I end these conversations as quickly as possible. But then why were you concerned, apparently, about critters getting to whatever you had in there? I think he was parking his stupid, big-ass truck in there. He has this massive black pickup that he never drives and leaves it parked out in front all day and all night. Best part is, he's always talking about how broke he is and says people are always trying to steal the truck. Makes sense to keep it, right? A couple of months ago, he started having a lady friend over. One time, she was having a terrible case of insomnia and stood in our shared stairwell sobbing about it loudly. I tweeted about it, neighbor saw the tweet, and sent a
"sorry"
text message, which is 1, insincere, and 2, he's not sorry. When I first moved in, he'd said something about,
"Hope I'm not too loud for you."
So he knows he's freaking loud. They would have loud sex and I heard whips. It would be at midnight sometimes. I eventually let him know I'd had it. I wasn't nice in my text messages about it. I even threatened to call the police, which I would probably never actually do. But his response made me hate him to his core.
"Go ahead, they'll probably laugh. Might even be some of my friends that show up."
Ah, yes. Nothing like a dip dookie old white man being a dip dookie old white man. And using the
"cops are my friends" line.
He ended up calling me a B-word too. And said,
"Oops, I bet your boyfriend doesn't like that either."
I said, "No, man. I am a baseball pitcher. I wear that label proudly. Also, people get baseball pitchy when they don't get sleep." I also told him I didn't want to be a jerk about it and mention it, but since he was being a jerk, I felt free. His CPAP machine is freaking loud and terrible, and I had not said anything because he obviously needs it. He coughs and wheezes loudly all the time. He plays his TV too loud. I let him know about all of it. His tone changed. He apologized. 2 texts later, he said,
"I'm not a butthole."
Actual LOL. Actual LOL, guy. Now it's spring. The raised garden bed is my sanctuary. Especially because I'm sick and tired of covering the virus as a reporter. I'll take murder and mayhem back any day. I used to volunteer on an organic farm in Florida and couldn't wait to find a space like this in my current city, where I can garden and get away from everything. It's remarkable. The man always has a load of trash to take out whenever I have work to do. One time, I'm up on my porch, standing next to the giant roll of chicken wire I just bought, and he says,
"Squirrels!"
And I said, "What about them?" And he said,
"They're thieves, whenever you start getting fruit."
I said, without expression and in a flat, uninterested tone, "Oh yeah, I bought some fencing." I gestured to what was next to me. He said,
"Oh,"
gave a pissed off look and walked away. I'm sure he was expecting a big smile and a,
"Gee, thank you for the wonderful advice, neighbor."
The other day, I'm out there working and he stops to chat. Of course, he asks me what I'm planting. I say nothing, really, yet. He gestures around to all of my potted plants. I say, "Oh, those. Broccoli, kale, lettuce." He says,
"Oh, no spinach?"
And I say, "No, I've never been big on spinach." He said,
"Oh, kale, but no spinach?"
And I didn't respond. He's previously made a trash run when I've been out working and asked me to grow sweet peppers. I already planned to, and he was never going to get any. Or anything else out of my garden, period. This is not a garden for you to make requests. I'm not here to serve you. He lingers. He said something about getting something to protect against field mice. There are no fields anywhere close, and I live in the city. He told me some cockamamie story about how, when he still lived with his wife, he would set traps for mice in the garden next to their house.
"My wife used to think I was crazy. I was crazy.
I can't snap.
I'd sit there just listening to them."
And his wife apparently said he was
hurting mice.
I just sort of nodded. He took his trash out and came back. By then, I was working on building a scarecrow of sorts out of 2 sticks and some old clothes. He asked me what I was making. "A scarecrow," I said. He stood there for a few more seconds as I wrapped garden twine around the 2 sticks. After not long, I looked up and asked, "Can I help you with something?"
He said, "No, no, I'm just looking. Just watching. Just so I know."
Like, what? What the heck? About 10 minutes later, he came out and asked if he could use the fire pit some mornings. I asked, "For?" He said,
"To make a fire."
I said, "No, I'd rather it just be me using this space." He said,
"I'm sorry,"
and gave me this mean man look that I'm sure was supposed to intimidate me. I cleared my throat and said, "I would prefer it just be me back here." He said,
"Oh yeah, it'll just be me, nobody else."
I said, "No, I mean just me." He said,
"Oh, okay,"
and went back inside. I just don't want to give him an excuse to be any closer to me or to be standing there watching me in my windows. Plus, boyfriend did not like hearing about this exchange at all. Additionally, we plan to buy a grate so we can cook food over the pit. And I don't want him screwing it all up. Plus, he's a drunk, so who knows, he might burn the freaking house down. He just wants something for nothing. The fire pit was full of soggy, dead, decaying leaves when I moved in. It's only usable for fires because I cleaned it out. The back patio and yard is only nice to hang out in because of all the weeding and landscaping I've done. I'm sure some of you read this and wonder why I chose to live here if this person lives here. The place is exactly what I wanted, for one, and I'm probably going to try to buy it. For two, I didn't meet this person before I moved in. Yes, that was a mistake, and I know it now. I'll also probably never live in a shared living space after this, and that was more or less the plan anyway. So that lesson is learned as well. I accept responsibility for all of these things, but I still maintain this. I should be able to just live my freaking life. I should be able to move into whatever property I want and live a life where nobody freaking bothers me. Why does this happen? Why is it this way? Why is it much better than it used to be when it comes to men creeping women? But I still feel creeped out in my own home. It's no longer a man's world and I just have to live in it. Men are not allowed to behave and act as this one has toward me. He was trying to get what he thinks he deserves. He wanted my reactions to his little jokes to be different. Please, mothers and fathers reading this, teach your sons to be better. Teach them they're not entitled to anyone else's body or conversation or anything. They're not entitled to a smile from every woman. They're not. And nobody is entitled to disguise themselves as a servant of the people when they're really just perverted drunkards trying to stick it in whatever walks by with an ass. Thanks for reading. Edits, I realize the end sounds a little preachy. Well, oh well. Maybe it's meant to. It's how I feel and I stand by it. As much as a lot of people love to deny it, nobody, not just random men, she was talking about men because that's, you know, who the situation was involving, but anyways, nobody's entitled to anything from anybody. Obviously, unless you're a parent or something, there's exceptions, but we're talking about, in general, a stranger to a stranger. The point is, this guy, even if you don't think his behavior was that weird, it was obviously making his neighbor very uncomfortable, and she told him multiple times, so that should have been taken seriously. And those who may be offended by what she wrote about old white men, because I know there's gonna be someone in the comments below, she's not talking about all old white men, she's not targeting old white men. She's just saying, who the hell says, oh, they're probably my friends other than old white men. Like, nobody says that. And it's not like she was saying old white men are bad. I'm just trying to freaking make sure no one gets offended in the comments. She's not trying to offend anyone. Unless you're a really creepy individual who needs their behavior checked, then yes, get offended and change yourself, please. Alright, you gotta be considerate of those living around you. And if you are an individual within the demographic she mentioned, and you are a respectful individual and a respectful neighbor, then thank you. You are a good person in a world full of bad people. Or should I say, r/bad people stories. Ah? Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.